looks like we've found it. Naturally, I'd love to come in with you, but I couldn't possibly put Medea in danger. I'm sure you'll do a fine job of finding the crystal ball without us. We'll be waiting here. You be careful in there.
Thank you.
Hmm? I don't often get visitors all the way up here. Well, now that you're here, maybe I could ask you a little favor. Okay, I'm only gonna say this once, so clean out your ears and get listening. If you go outside and look at the view from the top of the mountain, you should be able to spot a tree with red leaves. I had a bit of a kip there when I was out the other day, and it seems I left my tool bag behind. I don't expect you to do this for free, of course. I'll be able to give you a small reward. I'll be waiting here in my hut for you to bring it back. Try not to take too long. You found it. Let's see. Yep, this is the one. This is definitely my tool bag. Thanks. I suppose I'd better give you that reward I promised. Hmm? Hey, you there. That little mouse you got there is no normal mouse. It's your pet, is it? Right. Here, have this cheese as your reward. It may just be plain old cheese, but that mouse of yours is sure to like it. And I could be wrong, but try giving it some next time you've got yourself into a fight with some monsters. You never know what might happen. Anyway, that's enough noise out of me. Thanks again for bringing my bag back.
Well, well, you must be really brave to come up and talk to me like this. A bat that looked like a peddler came along earlier, but when he saw me, he ran away without saying a word. Anyway, as you've probably realized, you'll have to fight me if you want to go any further. What do you think? Brave enough for that, are you? I thought as much. Then you'd better be on your way. Really? You are brave. That means you must be a good fighter. I know. In recognition of your bravery, I'm going to let you through. Off you go. Be careful now. Do you, by any chance, think I'm a bit of a wimp? Well, I'm not, I tell you. If you don't believe me, why don't you try your luck and fight me? Oh, really? Then I suppose that's decided. Let's fight! Off guard. Ugh. But I suppose you want fair and square. Go on, you can pass.
Thank you.
Surprise! Surprise! Meet Giza. I am the master of this waterfall. Oh, how long has she been? How many people have gone and come? 10 long years and more. I've waited 10 years, I tell you. All the time hoping for the left one, I mean the right one, to come. But enough with the introductions. Now for the Truant of Muth. Does this Bristol call, crystal ball, belong to you? No, but I was sure you were the one. All the lonely years. Go then. My wait continues. Protocol. What? You again? I, Giza, am the master of this waterfall, I tell you. Oh, how long has she been? 10 long years. And now, then, have I asked you this B3? Yeah, before. Does this Bristol call crystal ball belong to you? At last! At last we fit mace to mace, you half-wit human! Now I'll teach you a moron. I mean, a lesson you won't forget. Pain. Oh, my old wound. Ever since I got this, I've not been right quite. And it's all because of you. What? You don't know what I'm talking about? Then you're not the true owner of this crystal ball. No! The shame! So strong. Strong enough to withstand my fearsome might. You are no fortune feller. Wait. Could you be... The waterfall rears many humors, you know. I hear that a castle called Trodane has been cursed. That it was overrun by thorns. And that only one person inside survived. He set off on a journey, leading a course and heart with a lone driver. as I thought. That was you! I don't know what you want with this crystal ball, but it's yours now. I accept the hand. Or is it defeat? One last thing. Should you meet the true owner of this crystal ball, tell him this from me. Don't throw things in the fall water! So, where we fell? Oh, the pain! The pain, the pain of my own! Oh.
I knew you would return before long. And it seems you have done as Valentina asked. You see, even with a glass ball, The great Kaldarasha's eyes see further than you realize. But you are meddling in matters that do not concern you. And you are wasting your time. You can bring back my crystal ball as many times as you like. I will just throw it away again. What? Don't throw things in the waterfall. It might open up an old wound. What on earth are you talking about? Enough. Listen to me. No one knows why I threw away my crystal ball. Even Valentina has no idea. I'm not about to confide in a stranger. Give it to me! This time I will smash it into a million pieces, so it never finds its way back to me again!
Stop! Please stop, Father! I know! I've known for ages! I know where you threw away your crystal ball!
You know? So you know about your real parents?
Yes. And I don't blame you for their death.
Why not? How can you not blame me, Valentina? How can you not hate me?
Because you were just fortune-telling. Just doing what you do best. I was too young to remember, but you were once a truly great fortune-teller, weren't you, Father? No one knew where my parents had fled to, but to you, it was as clear as day.
Ah. Back then, there was nothing I could not see. The great Kaldarasha was known all over the world. I was walking on air. Fortune-telling was my life. It was my soul. I thought only of myself. Be they good or bad, I cared not who asked me to use my crystal ball. I lived for the vision.
It's all right, Father. You're a good man. You took me in and raised me, didn't you? When I was just a helpless baby, I want to see it for myself. I want to see the great Kaldarasha in all his glory. I want to see your magnificent powers at work again, Father.
Oh, my sweet Valentina. So, you are awake at last. It is already past midday. You must have been exhausted. I must thank you and your friend. Look, I have put my crystal ball back where it belongs. Many years have passed since I gazed into the crystal like this. I have to thank you for returning it to me. What is this? Yes, yes, I see it, I see it. There is a jester breaking through the southern checkpoint. Yes, the mists are clearing. And the same jester murdered Master Rylos. Yes, yes, the mists are clearing. Can it be? Surely not. He has changed. But there can be no mistake. It has to be Master Rylos's former pupil, Dulmagos!
What?
Gov, he said Dulmagos, right? That's our man. That's the evil magician you and the old granddad are after, innit? So where'd he go after that? What else can you deduct?
What else? Let me look deeper. Huh? What's this? Yes, no question. This is definitely my old crystal ball, but look here. It has been chipped. It must have hit something very hard to do this damage. And look, someone has scratched some letters next to the chip. What? Half-wit? Who's the half-wit? What ignorant lowlife would do this to my crystal ball?
You what? When I ask what else you could see, I didn't mean on the ball, I meant in the ball. Whatever, I'll come and Gov.
Wait!
Thank you.
Thank you.
What happened? Did you do what the young girl asked? Well? What? Dulmagus killed Master Rylus? The same Dulmagus we're looking for? That fiend killed his own teacher? And you say he headed south? Then there's no time to lose. We must go after him at once. Let's be on our way.